Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? The Winter Triangle is formed by Betelgeuse, Sirius, and Procyon. And if you can see just barely kind of going through this area here, that's the Winter Milky Way. So we're looking away from the center of our galaxy when we're looking in that direction. And as a result, it's not as bright as the summer Milky Way. So if we pull up our markings, we can look at the galactic equator, and there it is going right through that section. So it would seem like there would be some really cool stuff in there, and there is, but there's not a lot of bright stars necessarily right in that area. And unfortunately, that makes it a little difficult to find some things. So when we kind of zoom in on that area, we go, okay, yes, Orion is over here to the side, Procyon's on the side, and then Sirius is way down here with some bright stars. But this middle section is really just kind of filled up by the constellation Monoceros, which is mostly fourth and fifth magnitude stars, unfortunately, although there's some neat things to see in there. And we're going to star hop to a really fantastic triple star. There's lots of double stars out there. Triple stars are a little bit more difficult to find because there's not that many of them, because they tend to have one component that gets thrown out unless they're far enough away, as they are in this case from each other, so they don't wind up being gravitationally unstable. So how do we find this particular star? Well, we can start from Orion. Let me get rid of actually our galactic plane here, our galactic equator. So we can start from this star, safe in Orion. And that's really the easiest way to go. But you can also kind of get a sense of where we're going to go by doing a little bit of geometry. If you take the measuring tool, you go from Sirius over to Betelgeuse. And about the third to 40% of the way across, we're going to be looking kind of right in this area. But that's a little further than a binocular field of view to go, because it's 10 degrees. So most binoculars are 5 to 7 degrees. So we want to try to go to this star right here first, but where we're actually going to wind up going to is this star, which is not far away from that one, which is within a binocular field of view. So we can do a quick star hop and use a finder scope as well, because we will need to use a telescope ultimately when we get there. Binoculars won't show these stars as well as we'd hope. So if we kind of zoom in on this area, we can see how safe is nice and bright, but let's back out and go to a binocular field of view. There we go, we got binoculars. And to go in the right direction, you can head just towards like Procyon, but there is actually a little bit of help from you in this sky here. So if you look at safe as kind of like the bottom of maybe an arrow or an arrowhead, you have this fifth magnitude star here, this fifth magnitude star here, and then this fifth magnitude star here. So they form kind of a nice arrow in the sky to guide you on the right direction. So if we head towards that star, now when we have that, we've got Gamma Monoceros in our field of view. So we're gonna go in that arrow direction, but then curve a little bit off towards Gamma like that. And once we do that, we're going to keep going in that direction and then curve just a little bit more, because there is Beta Monoceros, which is the star that we want to see. Beta is this awesome triple star. So if we zoom in on that, and this field of view that I'm showing you right here is at 150 times magnification. You'll notice what stellarium does is it tends to bloat the stars a little bit. So we have to kind of knock those down a little in order to be able to see them. So you can go to your absolute scale here like this and pull that down, and then the relative scale and pull that down. And then you can see that there's something happening there. You can see it's kind of getting elongated. Don't just have this big bloated circle. You've got something else going on, but we can't really see what's actually happening there. But this is about the view. Now it shows 150 on here in Stellarium, but if you look into your telescope, I saw this view at about half that. So around 75 times magnification, I was starting to see what appeared to be two stars pretty easily. Now I'm gonna need to bump this up in Stellarium, but I'm gonna show you what happens. So if I put on a Barlow lens, it knocks that right back up. I don't know why it does that. So I'm actually going to do this at three times so we can actually see this. You don't have to go up to 450 times magnification. This is just a stellarium function. So we're going to bring this absolute relative scale back down so we can actually see what's happening. And there it is. Go right there to about 20 and 20 each. And if you look, you can see there. See, it wants to move when I do that. There's three stars there. So two are very close together. They are about 3 arc seconds apart. Pretty close, but at 150 times magnification and a 6-inch telescope, I was able to split those. And the primary component, which is Beta Monoceros A, that's a mouthful, right? Is this star right here. That one is the primary star. It's about 7 degrees away from B, Beta Monoceros. And then that other one that's the furthest away, close to B, is C. Beta Monoceros C. This gets confusing. I think we should just call this something different. Maybe like the Monoceros triple? I don't know. Something different. There's quite the mouthful of things to talk about there. But these stars are interesting because they do look very similar in brightness, which is actually pretty unusual. Most double stars, especially triple stars, are very different in brightness. These are pretty similar. We've got A, which is at magnitude 4.6, B, which is at magnitude 5, and then C, which is magnitude 5.3. So those are pretty close. They're all around 18,000 degrees Kelvin, so pretty hot stars. They're all B-class stars. They were all formed about 30 million years ago or so. They do have different masses and different luminosities. The A star is really super bright. It's like 3,000 times the brightness of the sun, whereas the other two are like 16 and 1,300 times as bright as the sun. But they're all about 6 to 7 times as massive as the sun. So they're really super hot, very bright stars. And I really saw the blue color in all three of them. I thought it was very evident in a 6-inch telescope. So that's how you can find these stars in the night sky. You can even probably do it when the moon is out because they're bright enough. We're talking about 4th and 5th magnitude stars, so fairly bright. Just do that star hop and you'll be able to find your way to Beta Monoceros in the constellation Monoceros. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.